If civilization is to survive, we must cultivate the science of human relationships, the ability of all people of all kinds to live together in the same world at peace. Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
Beware the first taste. It breeds a hunger insatiable, wherein those who submit to the animal passions dig a bottomless pit with the shovels of their lies and try to fill it again with platitudes and empty excuses. They manipulate their wealth, status, and loved ones. Just a little more and I'll be okay. Sink not into the shining darkness of this Faustian bargain. For within lurk demons you can't possibly hope to control.
It was a gathering years ago, many, many years, centuries ago, that there was not all these interactive activities that we have now. But now we made it like islands. The religion is its own island on its own.
Across most religions and Arabs, Christians, Jews, there's a stream that says, love your neighbor as yourself. That's one of the principles. And I think if we go basically there, it's a question of humanity.
You mean our politicians have to be doing something different?
That's correct. The first thing that I would do is to be able to get up in front of this country or lobby the people who can get up in front of this country and say, you know what, we're gonna have to have some courage here, but we're gonna create an energy policy that makes sense. We're gonna stop polluting our world and we're gonna stop selling our souls.
I would have to sell the world on that. I would have to sell the country on that. That's not an easy thing to do.
Philosophers such as Plato and Pythagoras wrote books about this. It is a known fact among modern-day scientists that matter lives on forever. When we die, only the physical body dies. The soul lives on. It goes from form to form. We each have lived an endless number of lives and will continue to do so into the indefinite future. With each new reincarnation of the soul, we are presented with a brand new form and a completely new palette of new adventures to be revealed.
In my past life, I was lady in waiting in Russia. The ball, oh, dressed like a queen, not a lady in waiting. Oh, the tiara, the diamond earrings, the gown, the ermine, everything I wore. So beautiful. My favorite color, blue. Oh, those were the days of my past. Right here. And here, Rasputin. He was after me. He was after me. No, 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 no.
Once upon a time, the world was peaceful, beautiful. Well, most of the time. But a virus was sweeping across the land, a growing culture of secretive
baklava devouring people
had been developing in the underground world of Gotham's streets. Throughout the island, the symptoms of this infection were becoming apparent. In every street corner, in every sidewalk, in every bus stop, people wearing
coats. Deep in the pockets of these coats, a hidden bundle of baklava could be hid. Rushing to their apartments and locking themselves in, these addicts behaved in an increasingly alarming and convertedly clandestine manner.
Suspiciously and surreptitiously rushing about, they were deeply paranoid. Only one action relieved these symptoms. Clear as our story is revealed, that a small cult of individuals started discovering a particular breed of baklava, known at large as Sylvia's baklava. The small cult grew and grew exponentially until it was entirely and utterly out of control. The police could do nothing to stop the illegal trading of baklava, an activity that had enveloped and lured the lives of many youths and middle-aged individuals alike.
Any minute, man. Any minute. Could be too much.
Got a lot of money.
Where's the stuff, man? We're coming back every half hour. I'm fiending over here. I really need it.
Really good stuff. Just check back. Go get a bite. Go get a cookie. And by the time we
get a
like I'm floating. It's wonderful. It's a great feeling. I do it every day.
You do it every day?
Yes, I am. I'm very addicted to it.
And only this kind. Still gets back with
us. Yes. Just that drug. Very good drug.
And you?
Yeah, I do it like once or twice a day. Maybe sometimes even like do it all day if I wanted to. Because I just like it. That's why I do it. But it's good. But it's really, really good drug. It's nice. It's really nice. I feel like I'm flying, and I feel like it's up, all the way up, just not down, all the way up. It makes you high, and I love it.
I can neatly divide my life into two parts. The first part would be when I was good. And
love.
I was wholesome love. Was it the money, the wine, the women? And then I was just fine, and then I got lured into that world, and I died.
Thank you.
my God!
I lost my baklava now. I give you a call. Come on, come on. Come on inside!
I am Anzuma, and welcome to Anzuma's cooking show. I am a Middle Eastern woman, and not many Middle Eastern women get the chance in the cooking world today. But today, because I know my show is going to be a big hit with all of you, I'm going to show you my famous, world-famous Anzuma baklava recipe. From the Middle East and from my family, an ancient tradition, ancient secret that you're going to love. So much. So, please, write in with your comments, call if you like. We have lots of baklava, lots of cooking today, so tune in, enjoy.
Ευχαριστούμε τον Θεό που μας έφερε στην ημέρα αυτή.
What about us? We don't drink wine? What about me?
Oh, equal rights. You better don't get erased.
Moondance Pictures presents a Greek dessert film's production, Beyond Baklava. The fairy tale story of Sylvia's baklava.
I just got in from lunch. I had the best dessert. It's baklava. Do you know what that is? It's like this nuts and honey and like this phyllo dough and stuff. It is so good. It is so sweet. I loved it. It's neat. It's a treat. And it's made by all Greek mothers. Sylvia's baklava surpasses all the others.
I love her baklava.
Everybody wants baklava.
Our story begins in a suburb of Gotham, in the rainy month of April, where we find Wendy practicing diligently for an important audition.
What a beautiful day for a stroll. Stroll is walking. The
TikTok Diner, the best Greek food in the city.
Nothing like a great comic book. Wendy doesn't seem to grow up. Her grandmother Sylvia is concerned about this.
Why?
Take this.
It's in Greek though.
It's nice.
If you want, I explain to you. All right?
Wendy agrees to switch literature and asks for a favor.
All of my friends are asking for baklava.
I don't have today. Enough. Today I have a big headache. All right?
Every time I ask you, you say another time.
Do you think that the global insanity as it is right now, collective insanity, what I call, is resolvable and we can have peace and some kind of a consciousness that would actually entice our way to global peace?
I pray it will happen. I don't know if it's going to happen or not, but I sincerely pray that we won't explode ourselves out of the world.
Without a doubt, humanity was created for toil and struggle. Each trial raises our station. Each obstacle tempers the resolve of the will and the purity of the heart and soul.
At last, the day of Wendy's audition has arrived. It's a beautiful sunny morning, and Wendy takes the subway into Midtown. She has prepared for this audition for weeks.
What is Wendy Papa 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 Papa
But the song she sang was not quite his style.
Out! Out of my casting office! Out from my audition! Don't call us, okay? We call you, okay? Why you don't marry an American boy and change them? First of all, like I said, change the name, Wendy, Papa Galagalagal. What is this name here? Get out of here. I'm not gonna repeat it. Get out! Out! I don't wanna scream, get out of here! Out! Oh my God, what, those people, what do they want? What do they want in the, out!
Now there's someone who knows what he wants.
You, Wendy, change the last name. From Papagallo Puliski.
She changed Puliski?
Yes.
Never.
Yes.
Puliski.
Papagallo Puliski.
Great name. My grandfather was Puliski.
Δεν ταιριάζει. For her artistic career. So she did it fully.
Fully bird?
Also named Sally. She wants to have a singing telegram sent. Clarence, Endicott, and what? You want us to send flowers to your husband? All right. Can I help you? You can have a telegram sent out by nightfall. Okay. Call us again if you want one. Bye.
Come to me.
He just loves that baklava.
You know, there are a lot of pretentious cooks on this planet.
I am Anzuma.
The key to the baklava is it's a very long, extended process. In fact, it takes about 10 days to make one little piece of baklava. So I'm going to have 10 installments shown over pay-per-view. It's only $9.95 per episode, but you must tune in and give us your support and love. Thank you.
Yes, you've made the right choice. Come with me. I am Toula, Voula's sister. And in a moment, you're going to see Voula's wonders in the kitchen. And I'm going to be there too. But we must take this commercial break first. I'll be right back.
Now, about this pay-per-view, many people called in, asked me questions about this. Now, you have to send the $9.95 in, even on the days where we don't do the show. Now, I need your money. I need support. I'm on television. This costs a lot of money.
Hello, I'm back now, and I'm going to take my shirt off because it's very hot in here. So I am Toula. I have to offer the looks of the family, and Voula, she's got the hands and the brains, and she makes the best baklava, really.
So what I ask you to do, every show runs on Monday. We ask you to send in the $9.95 for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, even though the shows aren't on those days, Saturday and Sunday too, please. It will be a great, great help for me and my family and for my baklava.
With me, you're going to watch me while you eat the baklava at home, and it's going to be great. You wouldn't want to call.
You send in the shows on Monday, and you get it all throughout the week.
It will be a great, great help.
Okay, this is nothing. I'll do better things. Thank you. I have to be a millionaire.
And baklava for everyone.
Other people and the other networks, this crazy Aunt Zuma, this person cannot cook, and she looks like a man.
That's the worst baklava I've ever tasted. Worst. It's maggot-filled crap with the wrong amount of everything.
Hello? Who is that? It's Rasputin. I told you not to call here anymore. I can't get anyone to go to that part of town. I've asked each of my workers 4 times, and none of them will go. So look, I'd like to help you, but I don't know what to do. I can't pay them any more money. They won't do it no matter how much I pay them. Yes, who is it? A singing telegram? And can you sing? That's the main thing, you know. Sing Hot Cross Buns for me right now. I do have one job. Maybe you could try this afternoon. We'll try you out and see how you can do. It's to go up to a part of town that you may not have been to before, but it's very interesting up there.
I'm so happy that you're a part of my team. Now, it's very, very good that you'll be here to manage my business. I'll give you here the book of the entries of the orders for the next month. As you can see with all the hats, we have 1,000 different varieties, and as a result, they all must be shipped out. I just want you to be able to take everyone's name, number, telephone number, tell them where I'm traveling. I'll only be away for a couple weeks visiting the different branches around the world. I have many, many treasures in this apartment. Many of these are trophies that the officers have won. Hello.
Hi, it's Wendy from Singing Telegrams, USA Incorporated, for Ramona Marie Adelaide Dama.
Yes, come in, please. But, I mean, with all of these treasures here, maybe one day, as single woman I am, maybe one day it's all yours.
Okay, I'm an actress, I can do this. I'm an actress, I can do this. I'm an actress, I can do this. I'm gonna spin three times.
Down and see who's knocking at the door. Yes, hello.
Adelaida Maria Kieta from a secret admirer. Happy birthday to you.
Maria Adelaida Kieta.
Happy birthday. My secret admirer for you. It's a flower for you.
Go away.
Hey, well done. Imagine that girl just showed up when I needed her. Hi there, pussycat. You can't tell when something good is gonna happen to you, and I think we're gonna make a lot of money from it.
I
must get the door. Yes.
Good afternoon, Johnny at Singing Telegrams, Inc. Ramona? What? You don't want any more telegrams? You've been driven crazy by this guy? Rasputin?
Come to me now! Come to me!
Katina? Katina?
Eh?
Wendy is singing telegrams. You know this?
She's doing what?
Singing telegrams.
But Sylvia, really, I don't like her doing singing telegrams if it's the regular singing telegrams.
What about your classes in doctor? You should be a doctor. You should be an engineer, an architect, a pharmacist. What's that? Singing telegrams? Forget it. No money for that.
Nikos, why are you screaming at me? Venine, stuff to Quinto. She's not in the car.
Happy November first day, Mrs. Ramona, the Lady Maria Kieta.
There's no
happy
November first holiday.
From a secret admirer, I'm sorry, I forgot your flower.
Yes?
I'm sorry I forgot your flower, but here you can have the strain.
Go away.
It's from my own collection. Maybe my father was right. Maybe I should have become an engineer or a doctor.
How about a circus queen?
Shut up!
Someone gives me a train for babies. Boys, possibly, not girls. The Emperor of China sends me beautiful, hand-painted Chinese porcelain. It's exactly what I wanted. I have perfumes from Chanel and from all of the different designers. The Prince of Morocco has sent me his waterman and all of his jewels. Oh, how I love Morocco. But I do know who sent me the train. It's that stupid Rasputin. He has done this to me again. I will not put up with this. I will not put up with her. Hello, buddy. Yes. Yes, it's Ramona Maria Adelita Kieta. Listen, do I have one for you? If I push her off on you next week, could you interview her and get rid of her from my lifestyle? Okay, good buddy. Good boy. Bye-bye.
Singing telegrams aren't paying enough money.
If only her grandmother would give her the secret recipe.
Now what?
Mrs. Ramona Maria Adelita Kieta, I'm really sorry. I was very rude to you before. So I just want to say I'm sorry.
You
just had a long day. I don't get any tips.
Here, here's a card.
What?
A friend of mine. Call him in California on Monday.
Oh. A producer from California.
Hello?
Andrew Scott here for WJLP. Police are telling people in New York to avoid people who show these prime symptoms, those who are putting hands in their pockets, those who carry white plastic bags, those who are hurrying about in a very scattered way, or those who are hastily locking themselves in their apartments or not showing up to work or otherwise showing very disturbing behavior.
No, I am working on it. I can't get it. You try and get Sylvia's recipe. I don't have it. Yes, John Richard. Yes. I'll trade everything here in my business in New York and the world. I'll call you back if I get any closer to the entire recipe. You can count on my word. Ramona's. Thank you, John Richard. Thank you. Ramona Maria Adelita Kieta, it's your city.
Stress like this calls for a big piece of baklava.
What a treat.
This one came from Wendy, made by Sylvia as a thank you for the referral to the producer in Los Angeles.
Yeah, baby. I see someone I'd like to talk to. Hello, I'm Lady.
Hi.
Ramona Maria Adelita Kieta. Would you like to make a lot of money? I am looking for someone with the Greek recipe for baklava. I have a famous business here in this building, but if I could get someone who could give me a recipe, a secret ingredient like Sylvia's, you and I could make a lot of money.
This is how Atour expresses what happened to him in his own words.
I was doomed from the first word she spoke to me. I became her first emissary, a baklava ambassador, as she liked to call me.
You'll be one of my employees,
okay,
starting at a salary of $50,000.
My relationship with Ramona was very complex. Our love was destined for everlasting burning in the fires of hell. Like falling into a vicious, deadly whirlpool of quicksand, I was at once stripped of my innocence. I entered a world of the dark, a world where the money was fast, the women easy and the stakes very high. I got involved in the international underground black market trade of baklava.
The horror of thinking of the world exploding itself. Is this the most horrible thing in the world? I just cannot believe it, and I don't want it to happen to my children, their children, their children. I don't want it to ever happen in the world. It must not. But how can we make it not happen? Your grandmother, Sylvia, she makes a baklava recipe. I've got to have it. Follow me. Let's sit down at the table. Maybe I can bribe you. Dollars and cents, diamonds, jewels, whatever.
Do you have hats?
Hats. I make hats. Nothing but money's 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 money. All of this could be yours. Even the hats.